Everybody, I just wanted to make this video because I have a lot of things going on that I just felt like I wanted, or a lot of topics that I felt like I just wanted to talk about. And I didn't want to just like be talking to the camera, so I'm going to be doing my makeup while we do this, and hopefully I don't completely bore everyone to death, which is probably likely. I just got out of the shower, and so I'm just gonna put my contacts in real quick and then we can get this started. Okay, last night I was feeling really anxious for some reason. I have no clue why. I just started feeling a lot of anxiety to the point of like where I was getting nauseous, and I ended up only getting like 3 hours of sleep because of it. I was just like laying in bed trying to fall asleep, finding like ways or what the reason was that I was feeling this way. And I was just thinking about how I move away for college tomorrow. And I mean, I've lived away from home before. I studied abroad because I did through my community college. And I also lived legit away from home, about 3 hours north of where I live currently. And I was paying rent, paying utilities, doing all that fun stuff. And I just, a lot of bad things went wrong during that time. And I think that's part of why I'm feeling so much anxiety right now for this move, because during my last move, I felt really depressed and sad all the time, and I was just really unhappy and stressed out because of all the finances I had to cover, and just school was stressing me out because I didn't know what I wanted to do. Still don't know really what I want to do, but that's beside the point. I ended up having to move back home because I was just so unhappy with life and myself and everything, and that only took 5 months. So now that I'm moving out again, I'm just like really anxious that history is going to repeat itself, which I know it probably won't, because I have no choice but to live there because it's 2 hours away from my actual house, and there's no way I can move back home because I've worked so hard to be able to transfer to this school. And I think that's what has to do with it. I think that's why I'm feeling so anxious, which is like understandable because people, especially my age, being like 20 or gonna be 21 soon, dealing with the anxieties and stress that comes with moving into adulthood and starting to live on your own and pay your own bills and figure out what you want to do with your life and all the pressure and financial stress that comes with it. I think that's what probably worries me right now the most, financial burdens that I'm gonna have, because I'm already in like $500-$600 in credit card debt, and I just took out some loans, and I'm majoring in theater. So there isn't really like a secure job at the end of the tunnel of college for me. I mean, I am getting my teaching certificate, so there is some hope there, but really, I don't know what's gonna happen after college, and so I think that's what's probably the most terrifying, and that I don't know how I'm gonna be able to financially support myself, but I also am too stubborn and can't see myself doing anything else besides theater or teaching or something like that, so I will not major in anything else. What I'm going to be using for a moisturizer is the Aveeno Positively Radiant Daily Moisturizer. But yeah, as I was saying, I don't know. I've been really anxious about what the heck's going to happen for me after I get out of college, because I'm finally transferring, which means I have like 2, maybe 3 years left. That, I feels like not a lot of time to get my life together. And there's just so much I want to do. I want to be able to perform as like, I want to be able to perform as an actor, or maybe do backstage stuff. But I also want to travel and see the world and maybe teach English abroad. I don't even know. And it's just really terrifying that I still don't know what I want to do. And I'm just wondering maybe should I have chosen a more stable route, or should I Or am I doing the right thing by sticking with my passion? It's just a lot of anxieties that come with, you know, being in college. And I know pretty much everyone who, not even in college, just like everyone deals with this at one point in their life. And I know I'm not the only one dealing with it or going through it probably at this moment. No, I'm definitely not the only one going through it at this moment. But I haven't really talked to anyone about it before, and I didn't really know how to talk to people about it, I guess. Talking to people about it is just a whole nother thing. I could just go see a therapist, but it takes a month to get an appointment with a therapist at Kaiser, so here's my solution. I'm about to use a foundation as concealer. I'm using this Ben Nye cream foundation in the color Pass-3 Ivory. This is like theater makeup. I just had it and I was too lazy and broke to go buy actual concealer, so I'm using this cream foundation as my concealer. It works out. But yeah, so I've just been really nervous. I think also what makes me so nervous about going to the school is I pretty much know no one. Like, I have people where I kind of know them and like know of them, but we're not we're like acquaintances. We're not necessarily like friends. So I'm pretty much going into this blindly, which I don't know why that seems so scary for me, because I'm a pretty social person, and I feel like I don't have a lot of trouble making friends, which is why I'm so, like, not flabbergasted, but, like, I'm, like, kind of confused as to why I'm feeling as anxious as I am. Because I was kind of, like, this past night when I was, like, dying of crippling anxiety, I was just really confused by all of it. And I realized, you know, just because on the surface level I may feel like everything's alright, maybe there's some deeper stuff going on inside my head that I have yet to break the surface of. And that could just be because I like to bottle things in. Maybe not so much completely, but like I don't really necessarily bottle up my surface emotions, but I feel like on a deeper level I definitely do not talk about a lot of stuff that I feel, especially even to like my closest friends. I don't know, I just, there's a lot of stuff that goes on in here, and I feel like that's the case for everyone. I don't know, I'm just talking on the camera right now, I guess, to like see how people feel, and I'm pretty sure they're going through the same thing, and I guess I didn't want them to feel alone. And like, this is me kind of saying that they aren't alone, and there's other people like there like you. Other people out there like you. I don't know. What's been going on in your guys' lives, if anybody's actually watching this video? Tell me your deep concerns of adulthood, because I'm pretty sure most of everyone watching this video is around my age, because it's just people I know. Now I'm gonna be using this Ben Nye, again, theater makeup, fair translucent powder. And I'm gonna be putting it in this L'Oreal True Match thing. It's like literally gone, but I don't really have any other place to like put my powder in, so I just use this. I'm not very good at makeup, by the way. I'm just putting this all over my face. But yeah, other than the crippling anxiety that I'm feeling right now towards adulthood, I've also been like kind of figuring out just like who I am as a person, because I mean that's what everyone's doing right now. But I went through a breakup like almost 4 months ago, pretty much 4 months, almost 4 months ago, and it like kind of really hit me hard, even though the relationship was only 3 months, which sounds pathetic, and sounds pathetic that I still think about it. But you just wonder like how things went wrong, and you wonder what you could have done differently, if you even actually like mattered, or I don't know. Breakups are hard. Breakups are a very interesting time, and you start to like almost doubt yourself, which is like totally crazy, because you're still the same person you were before. So I don't know why this one event in your life makes you doubt who you are and your actions. But it shouldn't. It should not. The breakup should not be the thing that brings you down, even though I understand grief and dealing with that emotional trauma of a breakup. I mean, I don't know if trauma is the correct word, but just going from such this high to like a low, it's a significant change, and people deal with it all the time. And I feel like I just haven't really talked much about it. Like after the breakup, I was like really, really sad for a while, probably like for the month after it happened. And then I started like fully like getting okay again. I'm like not really think about it as much. Sometimes it'll like pop up here and there and I'll think about it and it'll make me sad for the moment, but then I move on because I realize that there's other opportunities out there for me to be able to love someone, and love comes in many different forms, not just romantically. You just give part of yourself to someone in a relationship, and then it feels like part of you was left there, and it takes a little while for you to like build that part of you back. But I've been working on it. I've been working on self-value and self-confidence and trying to find different ways to not let a relationship define my self-worth, I guess is the term. For my blush, I'm using this Ben Nye, again, theater makeup, because I'm too lazy to go to the store and actually buy real makeup. It's a Ben Nye Powder Blush in Dark 72 Fresh Coil. Coral. I don't know. It feels kind of nice to do this, like talk in front of a camera, which is weird to say. It feels like I'm talking to someone, even though I'm literally just by myself in my bedroom talking to myself, essentially. The physical motion of talking about your feelings, I think that's what's therapeutic about it. And this was kind of inspired by Ashley Best Dress. I don't know if you watches a YouTuber named Best Dress, but her name is Ashley. She just recently graduated college. We are the same age. She's 21, but I turned 21 this year too, so and she's great. She always talks about her feelings in like a chilled, laid back setting like this, and I feel like it's like a good opportunity to get the emotional baggage that you're feeling out and just like not have to feel the repercussions of how somebody would react until later on after you have like calmed down from talking about it. On a different note though, back to my original college point, I'm actually really excited to finally start at a new college. So I'm excited to start school. I've been doing pretty much nothing for the past month because I had a summer internship that I did for like 10 weeks and it ended like a month ago. And so I've been pretty much doing nothing, ready to start school and be productive again. I think that's probably what it is. I think I'm in a funk because I lack productivity. And I don't know if everybody feels this way, because I feel like I always have to be busy and I always have to be doing something to feel like I'm a valuable asset to society or something. I don't know. I'm gonna be using this like Bare Minerals. It's called Pure Radiance. It's literally just like this little shimmery stuff. I'm gonna use it as highlighter just because I packed pretty much everything else because I move legit like tomorrow. It literally does nothing, but I'm gonna keep using it anyways. I'm very excited to move and experience something new. I'm always a big fan of like changing things up and going somewhere new and making new friends and having new experiences. I don't know, which is why I was like so confused why I'm feeling so anxious. But talking about it now, I guess I've started to realize where that's deriving from. I guess last for my makeup is going to be this Maybelline Snapscara mascara in the color Pitch Black. Looks like this. I think what I want people to take away from this video is that I don't want anyone to think that events define your self-worth. And I really hope that people, you guys, don't let any event in life define your self-worth and who you are as a person, and that things do get better. And how you're feeling now, obviously, always temporary. And most of you probably know this, and you're probably, I don't even know who's still watching this video right now, but it's important that we identify our emotions and talk about them so that we're able to understand ourselves better and how we're feeling. And then that way we're not confused and we don't lash out and there is no complete terrible breakdowns. Crying and breaking down is okay, but it's understanding why we're crying and breaking down that's most important, I feel. And if we don't do that, then we'll just be stuck in this cycle of keeping everything in and blowing up and not understanding why we feel this way and just jumping to the conclusion that there's no hope and there's no and that it's always going to be like this. When reality, it's very important if we just identify our emotions and think about logically why we're feeling how we're feeling and take an emotional but logical approach to those feelings. I hope those who are still watching enjoyed this video. I don't really have much else to say. I just wanted to get a lot of stuff off my chest, and I haven't really been able to. I don't really have any opportunity to do that to anyone today, at least in person. So I just wanted to make this video, and hopefully you guys somewhat enjoyed it. If anybody in this video feels like they need someone to talk to or need some sort of release, I recommend either making a video like this for yourself and you don't have to post it, just like having an opportunity to talk to someone and feel like you're talking to someone, or feel free to message me. I'm pretty sure anybody who has this YouTube account probably has access to some sort of contact with me. Feel free to talk to me. I will be all ears. I'm not a licensed therapist, but I feel like I can be helpful in like a surface level kind of type of way. I hope everyone has a great day today, despite how you're feeling, how you may be feeling at this moment. It's important that we don't take our days for granted. We live life in the moment, and you are all beautiful people. You are all worthy and important. And I hope you have the best day today, because you never know, right? Right? All right.